All right. Hey, happy Friday, as Scott said. Welcome to the Shakespeare in Prison Network's virtual ongoing forever conference. We're delighted to have you here. We love seeing the familiar faces for our loyalists that are here. We get to see you every Friday. We're delighted to present Stratus Panourius, who is from Athens, and hopefully you heard his plenary that was pre-recorded. If you didn't, he's going to start with a presentation to catch you up to space, up to date. For my part, I recognize so many things, and I'm sure that those of you that are prison arts practitioners and have been in the prison, you will find a kinship in the discoveries that Stratus made going in and directing the Tempest. Of course, the documentary that Shakespeare Behind Bars is about the Tempest, so I recognize many things that he was discovering with the prisoners about the play itself. But then just his own personal discoveries as a practitioner, I think we'll find a lot of connection there with each of you that go in and work in the prison. So without any further delay, Stratus, how are you, my friend? You're coming to us from Athens, and you have a technical wizard with you, your son Nicholas. Stratus is of an age, as I am of an age, where technology, we're in the previous century, maybe even two centuries back. So we need our children, or we need Scott to be the one that helps us with this technology. So Stratus, how are you?
Hello from Athens. Hello to everybody. I'm so glad to be here with you. You make such a very beautiful work. It's fantastic. Thank you so much to have this opportunity to have the opportunity to show this try of Tempest in the main prison of Greece. Yes, I will begin with these small presentations with small texts and some photos because it is important to see the whole work in some photos in these three performances that we made, also Tempest, Ward number 6, Chekhov, and Glengarry Glen Rose by David Mamet. A short presentation with these silent photos so we can hear the soul of participants. Okay. This was the presentation.
Beautiful, Stratus. Thank you so much for putting that slideshow together and taking us inside the prison and showing us the production. It's really so powerful and valuable for us. I could not have created in my imagination what it is that you created in reality. As I was trying to think, well, what is an Athenian prison like? So thank you so much for that. This conference is centered around a theme, and that is why Shakespeare now? So could you talk a bit about why Shakespeare, the first production, why The Tempest? What led you to that decision?
I have worked so many years with theater, and when the National Theater and Underground Policy called me to build with social worker Yolanda Constantinidou the team, the first team, my first thought was Shakespeare. Immediately was Shakespeare. And we talk with Yolanda a lot of hours to have the opportunity to present the this writer inside the prison. And after 250 interviews, we make this team. And the first time that we said Shakespeare, nearly everybody know him. Can you imagine? Here in Athens, in the main prison, there isn't only Greek in this team. Comes from Albania, comes from Syria, and everybody nearly knew him. So what's wonderful, and after we find nearly 20 books inside the library that nobody have read it, these books. Now we have all the books inside. And maybe somewhere inside the prison, some thoughts of the Shakespeare writing down. Why Shakespeare? Because Shakespeare, we decide after 2-3 weeks work together, it's a phenomenon. Shakespeare is a phenomenon. It's like the weather. It comes from everywhere. And the participants say to me, after this performance, say to me, you know, Stratis, Shakespeare was together with us today, 21st of June in 1970. Shakespeare need truth in his place, and he was together with us.
Beautiful, beautiful. You talked in your plenary about human transformation, about the transformation that happened with you as an artist, the transformation that happened with your Miranda, who was a professional actor, the transformation of the prisoners, I'm very interested in this transformation because I have borne witness to it also, and it's miraculous. It's powerful, and it's not just that I'm there transforming them, they are transforming me. The prisoners as human beings are transforming me, making me a better human being, more compassionate, more empathetic, more understanding, all of those higher traits that we that we speak of, that we that I yearn for. Talk a bit about this transformation, perhaps from your standpoint, your discoveries, but then also from the prisoner's standpoint.
Yes. You know, Kurt, this experience to go inside the prison 2, 3, 4, 5 times a week is something very important. I spent so many days, weeks inside together with this team. And he, of course, because the ideas have transforming power in the life. And I will change my view of the world, of course, with Shakespeare, with participants, together we found so many new ideas, new many things. One thing I must say, all these participants now is out of prison, is free. All. In all these performances was 75 together, was in the beginning 25, and all is free. And nobody until now comes in the prison, nobody. It's amazing. I think this tell us that the power of the theater have a very important transformation power. We have so many experiences with the rehearsals, and of course when comes Miranda, professional actor from National Theater, it was like a miracle. It was like a miracle. Connect all the team immediately. And after, give to the rehearsal something very beautiful, like a flower. And the rehearsals continue for very quickly after this with Miranda. I will say one experience that they told me from the rehearsals. One cell don't have light, and the prisoners, the participants, they read Coriolanus, and the man outside, the guard, come inside and give light to read the book in the night. What you want? I want to read Shakespeare. Okay, I will give you the light. Okay. Many beautiful moments. Of course, a lot of them transform their names inside the prison. Hello, Prospero. Good evening, Gonzalo. Antonio, come here. and of course, the biggest amazing moment when Prospero said to us the books of Prospero and give us these are the books of Prospero Stratis, I must tell you. So many moments, so many, and of course, the time that was that comes the very moment of the first performance, when families come and see brother, father, everybody was amazing. Because in the very difficult time when somebody goes inside the prison, in this time with this performance, something transformed also the audience. It's like that. The transformation, it's not for only for me and participants, it for the spectators also. And also we have nearly 35 newspapers write about this performance. I will send you this all. It is also my webpage, this, and many more. So they transform the community to the prison. The view of community transform. So it many transformation.
Ah, oh, beautiful, beautiful. I hear so much of my own experience with this work in your voice, in your experience. It's what unites us. It's what connects us. It's what created the Shakespeare in Prison Network, because we oftentimes work in isolation, and when we create this network, then it's to hear colleagues tell their story, because we find ourselves in each other's story. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. I wanted to ask you about something that you talked about in your plenary. And it comes from, you referred to, and I'm going to butcher this, but is it Ionius Stovasius? You quote.
Yes.
You say things are done in four ways. Could you talk about that? Human behavior. Things are done in four ways, because you came to a great conclusion, or your participants came to a great conclusion about which of these are true for them and which are not.
Yeah, we talk this text. I have it here in the book. How was things happen? Luck, will, and two more. And we talk that the things happens exactly, these four things is exactly in the same moment when somebody do something. So it depends with consciousness of the moment. So all the participants understand these fourth laws. It was amazing. And comes these three lines comes from sixth century.
And those four things are need, right? Am I correct? The four things are come out of need.
Yeah.
And out of destiny.
Need.
Destiny.
Destiny. Will
choice,
and luck.
Yeah. And luck. Yes. Okay. So just to help the audience. So it's need. Need,
this.
Destiny.
These laws.
These laws, yes.
Yes. And altogether, see that the destiny is something man can build each moment, the destiny. And in one moment, you have these four laws. Life's laws, and they understand, okay, when I was there, 25 years old, was luck, was need, was will. And the fifth law is theater.
And one of the things that you said is that they saw the participants, the prisoners, that they saw their seemingly fatal choices that led them on the path that brought them to prison were either random events or necessity and not at will. and they discovered mm-hmm. or they shared with you that they found that the third law of conscious choice is rare.
Mm-hmm.
Conscious yeah. choice is rare. But then in the theater, we when we are actors and we're playing a character and we see what the character says and does, then we have to figure out, we have to connect. And so when they were playing the characters, did they see these laws functioning in the characters in the same way that they saw these laws functioning in themselves, and that conscious choice is rare?
One irony, it seems to me, is that the criminal justice system is based on the assumption that people commit crimes as that they choose to do this, like they're essentially sinning. As if they wake up one day and think, I know, I'll rob the 7-Eleven, you know, because I want to do something bad, you know, and this is just so preposterous that actually the people that I know in prison, their being there is overdetermined by their essentially terrible childhood experiences would be the most common thread.
Yeah, thank you, Johnny.
Yes, exactly, John, exactly. Many of the participants have no good child years. This thing comes from early life.
Mm.
Yeah.
And what you were saying about the fifth law being theater, you know, theater is all of a sudden a blessing in someone's life. They haven't had many blessings. They haven't had much good luck. You know, they haven't had much praise or they don't have much high self-esteem. And so to make theater gives them many, many blessings that they might not have experienced.
Yes, exactly, Johnny. Because it was the first theater workshop inside this prison, it's the main prison of Greece. There is seven wings in this prison. And when theater comes, it was like a miracle. Oh, we have theater now. What amazing thing happened. Yes, this is the fifth law. To connect all these laws to the life outside of the prison and rehabilitation also.
Yeah, one of the things, and I wonder if you find a connection with this, but one of the things that I talk about with the prisoners that I work with is that Shakespeare writes on an intellectual level. He writes on an emotional level. He writes on a spiritual level, and he writes on a metaphysical level. And at any moment, a character is acting out of their intellectual center or their emotional center, spiritual center, sometimes metaphysical with the ghosts and the fairies, those unexplainable creatures. Do you see a connection with that and these laws that the prisoners talked about, behavior, where behavior came from? What center they're in? Are they acting? Oftentimes, of course, the emotional center contains one emotion, anger. And they act out of anger, which oftentimes is destructive.
Thank you very much about this, Kurt. We talk a lot about how human manual works, how human machine works. Mm-hmm. And exactly when we talk about these three worlds, the world of ideas, the intellectual, the world of the body, and world from the emotions, everybody understand that immediately. Because like you said, connect lives with and put it in three roads. These three roads. And it was very beautiful because in the rehearsals, we talk with this. So understand also Caliban, Prospero, Ariel, something with connect with these three centers of the human being. And it was very helpful this for the participants also, because each moment they could play the roles behind these three centers, and like you said, the metaphysical world, because the words have icons, and each icon must connect these three centers to build an icon to send to the audience. So it was marvelous, because if I said this to the professional actors, they look at me like that. What do you say, Stratis? Okay, sorry.
I'm sure this was, just speaking about that, because that's so true, because I work in both worlds, and now I work almost exclusively in corrections, right? Because they're my favorite actors. I would rather work with them, because the professionals shut you down. Ah, you're crazy. But in the prisoner world, they think about it. They connect with it. It means something. So they haven't been ruined by training somewhere else. But how did your professional actor
one more time and then not for a while? Kurt, you were saying that Shakespeare writes on these different levels, and I'd like to ask you, Stratis, about another level that Shakespeare writes on, and it's a Greek word that you I think could illuminate for us, and the word is mythos. And so
mythos.
I think that Shakespeare is writing on that level as well. Would you say something about that?
Yes. Mythos, mythology. You understand, it's something very important. The word mythos in Greeks have ypsilon inside the word. It's writing like that. I will write you now. In chat, you see, this is can write in Greeks. Ypsilon is something to have, to take things, to keep things inside, and to. With this word, because I'm talking about this for the word mythos in Greeks, connect the the centuries, the spirit, the life with these stories. So mythos was, of course, very important, and it's a part of life. And, of course, this, of course, Shakespeare writes mythos in words, and they explore with this word their lives. Everybody feel like a mythos. Everybody built his history. So we connect the history of Shakespeare with the history of each one. And the roles past this and the roads coming in these roads. Everybody was a mythos, like a person, and the role also was a mythos. And these worlds, worlds comes together.
Beautiful, beautiful. We have a question in the chat. Kate, would you come in and ask Stratus your question?
Hello, Stratus. Thank you for sharing the photos. I'm wondering if you could talk, please, a little bit about your program's relationship to the prison administration. Were they welcoming? Did you have to woo them? How did that go?
Hello, Kate. Thank you. We'll be here. Our relationship with administration was perfect, marvelous. We have everything that we want. All the people that they work inside the prison was close to us. And sometimes we work also on Saturdays, Sundays. because this program comes also from anti-crime policy. We have together anti-crime policy, national theater, and this was very, very important. I don't know in Europe another group, theater in prison, that have the opportunity to collaborate with national theater. So this was very important to us to have these very big names together with us. And also because this performance transform also the workers inside the prison. Every day was very friendly to us. That's why we have this performance in the garden. It was amazing. We made a Shakespearean island inside a dystopian ocean.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Stratus, can you share your discovery of the bunk bed, which played such a significant role in your production? The bunk bed that we saw in the photos was part of your stage scenery. I love that. Talk to us about the power of that.
I didn't hear you. Can you one more time?
Yeah. No, we're having some connection issues. The bunk bed, your bunk beds.
Yes.
The discovery of that bed. And the power of that, and then how you used it and the meaning.
Yeah. You saw this in the photos, and I have read something. Everybody can read it inside the PDF that's inside the side, the bunk bed. So when I talk with the participants and also with the social worker Yolanda, we talk that if we put something outside, from outside world, inside the prison, it's not good. It comes from another world. This is another world. So we must find things that they have the life of the prison. And slowly, when I saw this object, immediately, I understand that was the island inside the island. This was the island inside the cell. The prisoner passed so many years in this in this island, small island, inside the cell. So was marvelous. And when we find it this, and we decide to have only one object, this small island inside the island. And because also the first time we decided to perform a Tempest inside the prison in a big, very big room. The second time we decided to play in the basketball area, and after comes inside the garden. I must say to you that maybe in the future we put it this band inside the garden like a sculpture, and this object make everything inside the performance, because all the participants they understand what is this object. So it's very familiar to the players, and we make very, very fun and very very beautiful rehearsals with this object. It comes from the prison. It's amazing. We take this object outside of the prison in the garden for 1 week.
Thank you. Leah, you have a question. Would you come in and ask Stratus?
Hi, Stratus. I noticed in the performance that it seemed to extend into the evening. And I would like to know if you could talk about the different security concerns that might have brought, the level of security of this institution, and how things like the evening, the time of day, even the costumes, which in my mind I go, oh my goodness, escape paraphernalia, and having a female actress, all things that brought up lots of interesting problems that I would have to deal with. So I'm curious about those things.
Thank you, Leah. Hello. This decision to make the performance around 8:30 in the evening. It's summer here, so the night comes after 9:30. Before this, we talk also with the administration of the prison. We talk also with anti-crime policy. And before this performance, we made a music evening. So comes out prisoners and see this evening, and the administration understands what's happened, and nothing happened. Nothing happened. And after this, we talk a lot with also about the security, and we have two performances. Oh, sorry, one performance to the prisoners. To the garden was around 100 prisoners, and nothing happened. After, we say that up to the sky, we didn't see helicopters, but we see birds. And yes. Was a marvelous thing, because nobody from the prisoners want to do something in the time of the performance, because they understand and they know that if something happened, if something small happened, they destroy everything in all prisons in Greece. And and that's why it was, and nobody wants to do anything. So was the marvelous thing to do theater with the lights and the participants to have the opportunity to see the sky. It was marvelous. When the performance finished in 21st of June, and we woke outside of the prison, it was not good thing, because we say that we go outside to drink a beer, but we are together with we are a group, so it's night, it's okay, it's warm, but we didn't do it. And the second thing about female actress, we talk also with the administration of prison. We talk about of course, social worker Yolanda, a lot about this. The artistic director of National Theater, Stathis Livathinos, we talk about this, and we have some interviews with this young actress to talk about something like a very special present to give theater to the with this performance. And after, we decide to invite Asimina with us, and was very beautiful this. Because Asimina comes anytime that I come inside the prison, sometimes 2, 3, 4, 5 times a week. 3 hours, 4 hours, 2 hours, 5 hours. And she was a part of the team together. She gave something very special to the team.
Beautiful, beautiful. We're coming to a close, and I don't want to leave without you telling us about your recently published book, Stratis. Would you tell us a bit about that?
About the
about,
public?
About, yeah, about your book.
Ah, okay. Okay, thank you, Kurt.
You're an author.
Thank you, Kurt. Yes. This is my book about Shakespeare on Mars. It's an e-book. Talks about also theater. Did you read it, Kurt? Yes or no?
No, I have not read it yet.
You must read it. And it's in Amazon. And talks about imaginary traveler Shakespeare in Athens. Talks about theater, talks about democracy. These two things that it's not so good in these times. This book comes after my this after Tempest. I think to write this book. It talks about Timon of Athens, and it's me very kind if somebody read it and write a review. Thank you, Kurt.
Yeah, the only reason that I haven't read it is it's in Kindle. Mm-hmm. We can only get it in Kindle on Amazon, and I have a great resentment for Kindle because I'm a book person. You can, I want to hold the
yes,
book. So you will send me.
You must wait about this.
Yeah, I know. I wait. I will wait. But you must send me the book with your signature, with your autograph on it.
Yes, of course. After,
yes,
it comes out, because with the pandemic, the publishers have be a very big problem with the books. Yeah. Yeah. They told me about the summer comes the book, but okay. If somebody wants to read it, e-book or Kindle book, it's okay. And
we do have it on Kindle, and it's very inexpensive. Kindle books are very inexpensive. But again, as I said, I'm old school. I have to hold it. I have to feel it. I have to smell it. I have to be able to write mm-hmm. on it. Well,
yes, it's like the theater.
Yes, yes, yes. Zoom theater. And
Zoom theater, yes. I must tell you that the Adikain policy say to us that begin again with the rehearsals on Mars, on March, not on Mars, on March, with the Persianus of Aeschylus.
Wonderful, wonderful. You go back to that, mm-hmm. you were rehearsing that. Yeah. When the pandemic shut you down.
Yes, they talk that maybe because that was a year that we didn't do anything inside the prison.
Yeah.
So they talk about this when the pandemic little go down, so we can go inside and
begin the rehearsal.
Yes, we are
participants that they wait. Yeah.
Yeah, we're patiently waiting here. Practitioners are getting vaccinated. We're waiting for the vaccine to come into the prisons, but basically in the American prisons, I don't know if this is true, but it appears to be true. Let's just let everybody just get it. And then we don't have to worry about vaccines. Almost in my prisons, the ones I work in, almost 80% of the prisoners have had the virus. So we don't know when we're going to be able to get back in. But we as practitioners won't be able to get back in unless we have the little card that says we've been vaccinated. Because the prisons, at least in the prisons I work in, that they will take no risk for that. So, Stratus, we're so happy to have you come and share your wonderful production of The Tempest and to be a part of the Shakespeare and Prison Network. You're one of the family now. You're adopted in. I think there's probably a good majority of us that are wanting to come to Athens for your next production in the prison. So could you begin preparations for that? We'll need hotels, we'll need transportation, we'll need food, you know, just, and you know, and we'll go out into the bars and oompa, we'll oompa.
Okay. Maybe I will come in September in Michigan, Kurt.
Yes. If we're open, I will host.
Who knows?
I will host you in Michigan. I know, because you're coming to the East Coast. So we love this connection. We love this international connection, and we love you sharing your work. We can feel in you the artist. We can feel in the artist the practitioner, and we can feel in the practitioner the work that we are so close to, which is with the marginalized, and that's what this family is all about, because they teach us. It's an honor because they teach us so much about what it means to be human. So thank you
so much, Stratus. It's great to have you in the family here, and we look forward to hearing much more from you in the weeks and months to come.